Why not? Oh.
After installing the mesh grill and microphone, I noticed that one of the standoffs was slightly bent. So using the end of my tweezers, I was able to bend it back into position so I could correctly install the bracket on top. Afterwards, there's a massive amount of tri-wing screws that I'll need to reinstall, which secure the rest of the antenna and flex cables in place for the upper portion of the...
It's pretty much guaranteed that video would pass 500,000 likes. So I'm gonna copy it.
It's now time to turn our attention to the lower portion of our iPhone housing, where I can install the mesh grills for the speaker and the microphone arrays. These were quite difficult to line up, but using a pair of tweezers, I was able to get them installed. I could then refasten our charging port into position. Apple uses adhesive around the speaker and microphone holes. In my case, those adhesive gaskets disintegrated when I removed the charging port. As I don't have any to replace them with, water could possibly enter the device if it were submerged. Although this could happen anyway, as the device was never fully waterproof. After installing the Taptic engine and speaker back into our iPhone 11 Pro Max, it's time to turn our attention to the battery. The battery that came out of here has a slight bend to it. Nothing alarming, so I'll just...
Was one of the first series started. The first one was actually...
I'll also apply some adhesive strips in a similar fashion to the original configuration. As I didn't have the specific battery tabs for this iPhone, I used some from an iPhone 10 and cut them to my needs. Applying them into position, I can press them down with a spudger, and we're good to go. Proceeding, I can install the device's logic board back into position and fasten its three screws. After reconnecting a flex cable, I'll get the three rear-facing cameras installed and reconnect a few other cables. After installing the gold tabs